opened a regional response center in Phoenix, which has equipment such as pumps and generators to be provided to any nuclear power plant within 24 hours to supplement on-site equipment as necessary. As a commissioner, I have great confidence in NRC's decision-making and Fukushima actions.
No doubt you do.
Throughout, the commission and our staff have relied upon solid principles of science, engineering, and risk management.
Oh, and payoffs. Don't forget the payoffs.
I appreciate the committee's oversight role and I look forward to your questions.
I want to thank you all for your testimony. Chair McFarlane, the NRC is still withholding two categories of documents related to the San Onofre investigation from this committee. You've repeatedly told me that the reason the NRC is withholding these documents is because of, quote, constitutional separation of powers concerns. Now, I asked a renowned, after working feverishly with your legal staff and my legal team and them, couldn't get the information. I asked a renowned constitutional scholar, Morton Rosenberg, who worked for CRS in the American Law Division for 35 years, and you have cited him often in your correspondence with us. This is what he says. He said, your letters to me demonstrate, and I quote, a profound misunderstanding of Congress's investigatory power and that they misstate court decisions, they ignore overwhelmingly contrary case law that supports the committee's right to receive the materials, and they show, quote, a lack of awareness of over 90 years of congressional investigations in which agencies have had to give Congress what it asked for. And I'm going to ask unanimous consent that I place his paper into the record at this time. Chairman McFarlane, you're clearly relying on misguided and deeply flawed legal advice, and it's time for you to decide for yourself. Will the NRC follow the law and give the committee what it has asked for or not?
Chairman Boxer, I would like to be clear.
I don't want to get caught up in a lie.
The commission has not come to its position lightly. We have spent much time and effort studying the situation, seeking views on the situation so that we feel we've been able to provide you with as much information as we believe that we can. There are two categories of documents that we feel we need to protect, but we trust
one is our
that
lies
the many,
and our
many
conniving
documents
with
that we've already
Southern
provided
California
you
Edison.
For your investigations have been helpful.
Well, let me just say, I appreciate, I mean, obviously the answer to my question is you're going to stick with the legal advice you've been given, which I am told by a scholar, is totally wrong. I didn't say you came to the decision lightly. I said you came to it wrongly. And so you still take that position. This committee is going to do its work. We're going to get these documents. And
thank God.
And when you read this analysis, and we'll send it to your team, we hope that you will change your mind, because it's very, very serious what is being withheld. We need to see it. And by the way, we'll get it one way or the other, but we need to have it. Now, many of you have said you're thrilled about the progress. Thrilled isn't your word. You're very pleased with the progress you're making post-Fukushima. So could we put up those 12 recommendations? As a matter of fact, you used words that, you know, exclaim all the progress, and from the chairman on down. So I'd like to ask you, as far as you know, have any of these 12 been implemented?
Some of them have been implemented.
Which ones have been implemented?
What we did at the commission after the near-term task force presented us with those 12 recommendations, we prioritized those recommendations three categories.
No. I'm asking you, these 12 recommendations that were made by your top staff, and you lauded them, all of you, I want to know, I have the answer, I just want to get
to the deny,
confirmed.
Withhold.
I have the answer. Not one of these has been implemented by industry on the ground.
Con
Do you disagree
mission.
With that?
Chairman, those are recommendations. Based on those recommendations, we issued a number of orders, a number of requests for information, and we've entered into a number of rulemakings, and we are still
I'm
in process.
I'm asking you a question. Has industry implemented any of these 12? They haven't. And so you can sit there and say you're proud and everything else. The fact is, not one of these has been implemented on the ground. It's 3 years and counting. Now, my last...
Madam Chairman, I'd like to hear from the commission where they are in the process.
Well, I know. Well, I'm running out of time, so you can ask it on your time.
All
right. Could you add another 10 seconds on, please? Now, this last question is very important because it deals with a decision you made, which is to keep the spent fuels where they are and not move them to dry casks. And in that decision, you assumed emergency planning at these plants would be in place. So I am asking each of you a very important question. You saw the photo. Could you show the photo one more time of how close that fire came to San Onofre, where it's 8 million of our people live within 50 miles. When I saw that, my heart stopped. I assume yours heart stopped too. Now, that plant is shut down, and there's these fuel rods that are hot right there. You've decided not to move them. I am asking you each, if you are asked to waive the requirement that this plant have an evacuation plan in place, if you are asked to waive that, will you deny that request? You're making a face like you didn't understand, so I'll say it again. You have been asked, as I understand it, by the operator to waive the requirement that there be emergency evacuations planning at that site. They don't want to do it anymore. They don't want to have the sirens. They don't want to have the plans. 8 million people, a fire came within half a mile. Will you deny that request? I'm asking you yes or no.
Exemptions are not waivers. The plant may have applied for an exemption. That is not a waiver. And
it's fine. Emergency call it an exemption. Will you deny the exemption?
Emergency preparedness at decommissioning plants may, in some cases, be reduced in scope, but it will not be eliminated. I want to be clear on that. And exemptions for decommissioning plants are done on a site-specific basis.
So I'm asking,
they are carefully considered.
Will you deny the exemption from safety for this plant when it is presented?
We will
yes
always,
or, no, or
we will,
you don't know.
We will ensure that the plant will be safe.
That's not my answer. That's not the answer to my question. Say yes or no, or I don't know, or I can't answer it.
We will ensure.
Will you deny a request for an exemption?
We will
from
ensure
any emergency plans.
We'll
you
ensure that
it?
The plant will
you,
be safe.
You won't it's answer a, it.
There will be.
Madam Chair, will you let our witnesses answer your question?
She won't.
I mean, the way it normally works is you get to ask the question, but they do get to answer.
Will you answer yes or no, or I don't know? I don't need a lengthy explanation because my question is quite simple. Will you vote to deny an exemption from safety rules from the operator at San Onofre? Yes, no, or I don't know yet.
As I said, exemptions are done on a site-specific basis, and they're based on an established process.
The more you talk, the more you ignore my question. I'm asking you, I'm giving you three choices. They're fair. Yes, no, I don't know.
Madam Chair, we don't normally have hearings requiring
Excuse
the witnesses
me.
To fill
if
in
when you have this gavel,
S-form.
You make the rules. Yes, no, or I don't
better,
know.
Better.
Would you please answer?
At this point in You'll time, I have not been presented with enough information to make a decision.
Then you don't know. Honorable Svinicki.
Respectfully, Chairman, I won't prejudge the action, so I don't know.
Oh!
I don't know either.
Yes?
I haven't seen the exemption request yet. I agree with my colleagues.
Great.
Yeah,
well,
great.
Let me just say, for the record, never has the NRC ever denied a request for an exemption from safety. Now, I got to tell you, this is in my mind, it's in my heart, and the people in my state expect you to protect them. The fact that you cannot commit today to uphold the safety planning for this plant, given that the number of fuel rods that are in there are far greater than the plant was planned for, which you allowed, not saying you, but the commission allowed. It's outrageous. And you wonder why people are losing confidence. Senator Vitter.